Folks, these are the Odyssey Mobius headphones. And to give you a little bit of context, Odyssey is a very reputable brand in the audio industry. They make headphones that cost as much as $4,000. So they're pretty serious about this stuff. Now, the Mobius lineup was initially backed up by an Indiegogo campaign, and they're now currently in full production and available to buy. How much, you may ask? Well, take 10 off of those 4,000s and you've got yourself a headset that primarily focuses on 3D audio by taking advantage of the planar magnetic drivers.
Plus, it's got other things like 7.1 virtual surround sound, high-res audio certification, and just a lot more. So that's why it costs so much.
Now, to make things fair, I'm gonna break things down as simple and in-depth as possible because there's a lot to cover here with the Mobius. So I'll leave timestamps down below and right over here so you can actually, you know, scroll to that particular segment that you're interested in. But yeah, I'm just gonna wait here for a second so you can take a look at all the different segments before we get this thing cooking. All right, time's up. A quick message from our sponsor. The new Razer Blade Stealth defines portability without compromising on performance. Featuring Intel's latest 8th-gen CPU and NVIDIA MX150 GPU, up to 16 GB of memory and up to 13 hours of battery life, experience some of the most popular games wherever you are. Learn more about the Blade Stealth down below. Okay, so let's get the basics out of the way. The build quality is fantastic, and that should be expected for a $400 headset. The body is mostly made out of hard plastic materials, but they're put together really well. There were no signs of creaking, which is nice. The material itself is coated in this silicon rubberized material that gives it a cool stealth and matte black finish, and I like that. There's nothing really aggressive in terms of design with the Mobius. I think it'll fit in within any environment, be it an office setting or when you're traveling or even gaming. You can pick this up in both copper and blue accents or this carbon model that I have over here as well. The headband is not self-adjustable and it uses the standard sliders, but I have to admit, I'm not a fan of the sliding mechanism. It's just too tight and requires quite a bit of force to find the right setting. Sure, it does keep things in place, but I've seen better on cheaper headsets. If you have a bigger head, you shouldn't have a problem wearing this, although keep in mind that the clamping force is a bit aggressive at the maximum setting. I personally didn't encounter any issues with my medium-sized head, so I was comfortably able to wear this for longer periods of time. Another thing that should be noted is that the headset itself is quite heavy, coming at around 350 grams, so if you're not really a fan of heavier headsets, this will certainly get some time getting used to. It certainly did for me personally, because coming from my AKG K7Xs, which are quite light, coming in around 250 grams or something like that, it's definitely noticeable because there's a lot of tech packed inside this body. The ear cups do rotate 90 degrees so you can rest the Mobius around your neck without experiencing any discomforts. The ear pads are made out of artificial leather and they do feature a good amount of memory foam to create a good seal around your ears. They also do a great job preventing your ears from making contact with the drivers, but if you're wearing these for longer periods of time, expect sweat accumulation, especially in warmer environments, so I'd recommend venting your ears often. Out of the box, you get a carrying bag along with a few cables. I should mention that the Mobius is a versatile headset, so the cables are detachable. So you get a Type A to Type C and Type C to Type C, since it does use that interface, which is very refreshing to see on a headset in 2019. Kudos to Odyssey for that. But the cables themselves are pretty short. The USB ones are 1.5 meters in length, whereas the analog 3.5 millimeter cables is only 1.2 meters long, so routing it behind your PC will certainly be a bit challenging. It's just something that I really wished Odyssey gave just a bit more thought process into, because realistically, at least for my use case scenario, I was able to plug this into the side of my monitor because, you know, it has USB ports, but not everyone does. So I guess the only solution that I see myself for this is to, you know, get an extended USB-C to Type-A cable that also, you know, transfers power and data. But then again, I didn't really have a longer cable to validate that, so yeah. I mean, for $400, they could have done a little bit better. The cables themselves are not braided, which is great because you won't experience reverberations as you're maneuvering your head around, and it also prevents the mic from picking up those slight noises. However, they aren't as flexible as I'd like them to be, especially when routing it around my keyboard or a certain object that's in between. Now, here comes the important stuff in terms of connectivity. You can use the Mobius in wired mode via USB or analog, or wireless via Bluetooth. But keep in mind that there is an internal DSP and amp built into the headset that processes 3D audio, your standard stereo mode, either in high-res 24-bit 96K or the regular 16-bit 48K and virtual 7.1 surround sound. That means regardless of you being in wireless or wired mode, it still uses the internal battery to process the signal, except when it's plugged in via USB, because that charges the headset while also being in use. This is a bit disappointing because if you want to plug in the headset via analog to an Xbox One or PS4 controller, or even your smartphone, provided that it has a headphone jack, you're going to have to make sure that the battery is fully charged, because if there's no battery, there's no audio whatsoever, even when it's plugged in via wired mode via analog. Which kind of sucks, because the other disappointing part is that the battery life is only rated to last for 10 hours, which is very poor, especially compared to the competition. But considering that this has a lot of tech featured inside, I guess I could give it a pass. But ultimately, this comes down to your use case scenario. If you're thinking about using these in wired mode for the most part, I don't think you should have any issues. But if you're thinking of switching between wired and wireless, that battery is definitely something to be noted. Speaking of wireless, I just want to quickly talk about the codecs that they support over Bluetooth. So it supports SBC, which is the lowest possible bitrate, and then it has AAC support and LDAC support, which is the highest bitrate that you can find on a smartphone. My Galaxy S10 had no issues streaming music with that codec. I'm pretty sure most Android phones shouldn't have a problem, but if you are on an iPhone, you're only restricted to AAC, so do keep that in mind. But ultimately, the source of the audio is also important. So if you're listening to FLAC files via Bluetooth, LDAC is probably the best way to go. But honestly, for Apple Music and other streaming services, you're pretty much okay with AAC and just the regular codecs. In terms of controls, there are lots of buttons to get accustomed to, and most of them are located on the left ear cup rather than a dedicated control box with the cable. The power button is used to turn on the headset as well as activate Bluetooth pairing. 3D audio button is something that cycles between manual mode and auto mode, as well as switching between input sources like aux in, USB, or Bluetooth, and it also can be used to calibrate the gyroscope. There are also dedicated volume adjustments for both your headphones and microphones, and the scroll steps are well defined, and they do change in two-step intervals. There's also mic mute switch on the ear cup that's easy to reach. Basically, there's a lot of gestures baked into the Mobius, so I'm just gonna leave this shot right over here that goes over everything. So do feel free to pause and go over them if you're really interested. For inputs, there's an analog in for the detachable boom microphone, and there's also an analog out for the wired connection. You also got a USB Type-C port that acts as a charging port as well, and there's an LED indicator that shows the status. All right, so I think it's time to talk about the star of the show, and that is 3D audio. What exactly is it? Well, essentially, Odyssey teamed up with Waves NX technology to incorporate real-time head tracking. And they've done this by incorporating gyroscopes in the headset that essentially creates an establish a location for a source regardless of your head movement. So for instance, when you have 3D mode enabled, the Mobius positions the source of your sound, whether if it's a soundtrack, a movie, or a game, right at the center. So as you're maneuvering your head around, the drivers themselves dynamically shift between left and right, almost making you feel as if there are a set of speakers right in front of you. And it almost makes you feel like you're in this space with audio around you. And I'm not sure if that's the right way to put it, but it's really fun, guys. So for one, it maintains the wider soundstage. And if you just casually sit back at a certain distance off of your display, it really gets immersive. For instance, if you're checking your phone or doing something else for a second while watching a movie or something, you automatically become aware of the fact that there's something important happening at that second in front of you that just grasps your attention, and it's really cool. Now, some of you may end up not liking 3D audio, and that's totally okay because you can turn it off. But for those of you who really want to take your content consuming experience just a step further, this is certainly a cool feature to try out. And the other interesting thing is that, you know, it's something that can also be used if you're watching a movie in your lit couch or something like that when you don't want to disturb someone else. Like, for instance, I live in an apartment setting, so if I don't want to crank out tunes or anything like that, then this is another way to kind of experience that immersion, which I really appreciate. However, I do have to point out that certain frequencies, especially the bass, doesn't really sound as deep and tight as I'd like it to be when compared to the high-res mode, or when I switch over to the high-res mode on this headset, which I'll talk about a little bit later. That's because 3D audio is only available in the 16-bit 48K stereo mode, so it's a little bit less compressed compared to high-res, and that's kind of something to keep note of because it's first-gen tech. There's still a lot of development that needs to be done with 3D audio, so there's that. But I also wanted to try out gaming to see if it actually makes a difference, and to be honest, it really doesn't, because hear me out for a second. When you're gaming, you're basically tied down to your monitor. You're not going to be looking at your mouse or your keyboard because you want to be focused in the moment at that second, and there's just no other time to process the rest of the stuff that's going around your head. And I don't think 3D mode will add an extra advantage because it doesn't make you a better gamer. For sure, it doesn't help me spot my enemies because, you know, I'm staring at the screen, I'm in the moment, and I'm trying to focus on my gameplay rather than processing all those audio cues. So you're actually better off, you know, trying it out on stereo mode. But realistically speaking, 3D audio, to me personally, just didn't make a significant difference, or it didn't create an impact when I was gaming. There are two 3D modes with the Mobius. So there's auto and there's manual. Manual essentially sets the source right at the center. So regardless of your head movement, it just stays there. But when you set things to auto, it actually switches that stereo or the center signal, or I want to say the source, regardless of the position of your head. So it actually takes a few seconds to dynamically shift that source. Personally speaking, it actually does not sound that great because sometimes the balance just goes completely off because, for instance, if I just turn over to the right, the source takes a little bit longer to get to that position. And when I turn back for a second, the audio is completely off balance. Like, you can hear a lot of the audio from the right driver versus the left. So it's really not quite complete. So that's definitely something that I noticed when using 3D auto. So if you really want to try 3D, you should definitely try manual because that's the best way to experience it. So with 3D mode off, how does a headphone actually sound? Because a lot of people are actually interested in that as well. And to be honest, this is where the Mobius shines at its best. They feature planar magnetic drivers that's quite unique compared to what you'd find on a mainstream gaming headset because they work off two magnetic fields that cause motion resulting in sound reproduction. And guys, it is phenomenal. The sound stage is surprisingly wide for a closed back pair of headphones, and there's fantastic definition in the higher ends, complemented by a deep, tight bass that just immerses you into the type of content you're listening to. Even the slightest details in the mid frequencies are well pronounced on the Mobius, and it's something that I just haven't personally experienced on another gaming headset. And that's good, especially for $400. This also ties really well with gaming as well. The wider soundstage gives you great detail and it allows you to identify your enemies fairly well. Gunshots were blooming and awesome, and there's nothing really, again, to complain about the Mobius in gaming, especially when you enable this thing in stereo mode, high res that is. And I think they completely nailed it in the sound quality department. It's definitely an awesome experience, something that you should definitely try out if you get the chance. There's also a virtual 7.1 surround sound mode on this headset. And to be short, it's not that great, especially compared to what Logitech does with their surround sound features. So yeah, completely avoid that. It's, again, something that they're trying to pack too much into this headset. And I just feel like they could have just avoided that. But hey, if it's a marketing thing, right? That's what they do. The sound quality over Bluetooth was also pretty good. I mean, I was using the LDAC codec to stream music, which was great. And I was actually listening to some FLAC files from my phone. And I gotta be honest, guys, it's one of a kind. It's one of an experience. Now, the range, to be particular, is not that great. It's actually pretty poor. I mean, I was kind of walking around the kitchen downstairs. I left my phone here in the office, but I ended up experiencing a lot of interruptions as I was walking around the office. So definitely something to keep note of, especially when you decide to leave your phone at a relatively longer distance. Moving on to the microphone test, and this is what it actually sounds like. So my vocals they're well pronounced, but I think there's a lot of processing going on in the background because, as you can see, I mean, there's less background noise. That's probably one of the things that you'll notice, but my voice just doesn't sound natural and boomy as you'd normally find with other gaming headsets. I'm going to compare it to the HyperX Mix in just a moment, but here's a shot of, or I guess here's a sound test or sample of me typing on a mechanical keyboard featuring Cherry MX Blue switches, so you can get a rough idea on how it does. I think it's trying so hard to eliminate that noise, but it doesn't sound $400 good. Now, to make things fair for the comparison to the Cloud Mix, I'm going to read this little paragraph from the manual of the Mobius. I mean, they've used some interesting choice of words here, so it's structured really well. Here we go. It's time for some advanced tactics for those brave and experienced. These controls will add further efficiency in your travels throughout the space of audio. Mobius is the true Omni tool. Use it wisely and don't mix up your buttons. It's time for some advanced tactics for those brave and experienced. These controls will add further efficiency in your travels throughout the space of audio. Mobius is the true Omni tool. Use it wisely and don't mix up your buttons. So yeah, let me know what you guys think about the microphone test comparing, you know, the Cloud Mix and the Mobius. Which one do you prefer? I mean, I personally like the natural kind of boomy
sound that I'm getting out of the Cloud Mix versus the processed sound on the Mobius.
And the last thing to cover here is the driver software. And to be honest, I really wished if the design team took just a little bit more effort to make it a little bit more cleaner and minimal. But you can still, you know, go through different adjustments like setting the ambience or the spatial sound that you want to set when you enable 3D mode, which is pretty cool. You also get this real-time head tracking feature, or I guess a physical overview of how your head moves, and it gives you a realistic scenario as to when you're moving your head, which is pretty cool. You can also go through different sound effects, sound profiles to be more precise, and there are multiple, there are actually a lot of them that you can cycle between. And you also have the option to monitor the status of the battery. And that's pretty much it. There are no sorts of RGB lighting or anything like that implemented on this headset, which I'm really glad that they did. So I guess this brings us to the conclusion. And guys, the Mobius by Odyssey is a novelty item. I certainly think it is, because this is an interesting entry into the gaming market, especially for a company like Odyssey. They really wanted to deliver something a little bit more than your average gaming headset, and they've done that by implementing add-ons like 3D audio on top of the fantastic planar magnetic drivers that deliver fantastic audiophile grade experience. It really is amazing, especially when you turn this in stereo mode, listen to some tunes, play games, and if you're watching movies, it's one of an experience. You really have to try it out to kind of appreciate the quality and of course the work that has gone into something like this. But $400 is a lot. I mean, especially for an average gamer, I don't think he or she might be willing to spend that much on a gaming headset. But if you're someone who's used to an average gaming headset that costs somewhere between $100 and $150, and if you're looking for that extra step up in terms of audio quality without sacrificing on that gaming aspect of it, and if you want to try something cool like 3D audio, the Mobius is something worth trying. That being said, there are some quirks with the Mobius. For instance, the cable is too short, it's not too flexible, so practically speaking, it just wouldn't suit a proper gaming setup. The microphone quality is, I mean, I really want to know your thoughts about that in the comments, because I personally wasn't really impressed for $400. Lastly, there's the battery factor, because if you're planning on hooking this up with an Xbox One or PS4 controller, you have to make sure that the battery is fully charged, because otherwise, even via analog mode, you won't be getting any audio signal if this thing completely dies. So there are a lot of things to consider. You really have to think twice before pulling the trigger. So let me know what you guys think about 3D audio and of course the Mobius by Odyssey. I'd love to know your thoughts about it in the comments. Make sure to check out certain relevant content over here. Subscribe to our Boot Sequence channel. I'm signing off. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.